Kumbh Mela is one of the largest, actually the largest peaceful gathering of yogis and mystics and people of the Hindu faith from India and throughout the world. And of course there are tourists, everybody who's interested in the Indian mysticism wants to know about this Mela or the festival. Some call it a carnival as well. And the story of the Kumbh is that during medieval Hinduism, there was a churning of the ocean, and the purpose of the churning was to find out the nectar of immortality that's hidden deep underneath the ocean. And both the deities and the demons figured out that if they churned the ocean in a certain way, called a samudra manthan, that they'd be able to get this nectar out. And eventually, through the way the story goes is, the nectar came out in a pitcher, and if the demons were given this nectar, they would have become immortal. So all the devas or the deities wanted to save the this nectar from going to the demons. And Vishnu takes a certain form, and eventually he's running with this pitcher and throughout the heavens. And while he's doing so, a few drops of the nectar fall down in four different rivers along India. Sangam, where we are at right now, which is the confluence of the Ganga or the Ganges, Yamuna, and the legendary hidden Saraswati, was one such place where this drop of nectar fell. And the time, the exact time when this episode happened, is celebrated as the Kumbha Mela. The word Kumbh comes from two roots. One is the name of the constellation during which this Mela happens is called Kumbh. At the same time, Kumbh also refers to the pitcher of nectar in this case. So so that's why it makes you know, there is this belief that if you take a bath in these holy waters during these auspicious times, you get relieved of all your sins of the past, and of course find your way into liberation or immortality from this circle of birth and death. Oh.